You're starting as a programmer, but you don't have proper projects to put in your resume, right? Or CV, sometimes we call it. Well, worry no more, because in this video, I'll be talking about three Python projects that you should master as a beginner. And just because of these Python projects, my students have been able to land a great career and great jobs in big companies also. So I'll be sharing with you three projects that every Python programmer, even a beginner, should master. And quickly, if you code all these things, like I'll be telling you three projects, and once you code all these projects, don't forget to leave a comment down below with a GitHub link of it so that I can check it out. I can see how you are doing, and many of the other people watching this video can also do the same to your projects, right? And so everybody can be inspired and take inspiration from your projects. So the number one my Python project that you must master as a beginner is developer's portfolio. Now, it is really crucial to make your portfolio. And why? It's not just for your practice, it's not just for your resume, but also for creating an online presence. At this age of information, everybody, like every next company, wants his employees to have some kind of website with proper portfolio on it, right? So you can create a developer's portfolio. It's not only beneficial from a development side, not only for your practice and not only for your project, but also for your future purpose, like showing it to your potential companies, right? To get a potential jobs, or even showing to freelance clients or whatever it is for you. So you must create a developer's portfolio. I personally suggest you use Django if you're using Python. And if you're using other programming languages, you can choose other programming languages. But in Python, I would say you can go with Django, and it's really important for you to create a good looking site. So you must also understand HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and all these designing languages. So once you have this developer's portfolio, you can also add more of these projects into that. So it's more, you can use it again and again. And when you are coding this developer's portfolio, don't think that you are making that developer's portfolio for you. Just think that you are making that for a paid client, that someone is paying you to do that, and you are making it for them, right? So that you will get a good quality developer's portfolio that you can present to your potential clients and leads. So number two is tic-tac-toe. So game development is really fun to do, and especially in Python, it's really awesome to do game development. And I would say this is a terminal-based game. So tic-tac-toe, you know tic-tac-toe, right? There will be a circle, cross, like that thing, right? I'll just put up an example over here. So that's what tic-tac-toe is. Why I'm saying you to create this project is to enhance your problem-solving capacity. Well, I can't emphasize more than this, that problem-solving capacity is so crucial for you to be a good programmer, because it's not about syntax. I always tell this, programming is like a war. You remember what happens in war? There are two important factors that are needed in war. One is weapon, one is strategy. Without weapon, you can't go with just with strategy. Well, maybe you can, but without strategy, weapon is useless, right? Maybe you'll shoot to yourself, or I don't know what will happen. So take syntax as your weapon and strategy as the logic, right? So you must understand what is your logic to create that program. So this Python project, tic-tac-toe, will help you to enhance your logical capacity and your thinking capacity and how you actually think about problems, right? Because you'll have to think about all these different test cases, like what to do in this case, right? All these things. I made a quick video on how you can make tic-tac-toe. You can go over I button somewhere up there and check that out, right? And you can also get some idea about how you can create a tic-tac-toe project on Python. Third project that every Python programmer should master is movie listing website. Now, why I'm saying movie listing website? The first two projects were for, one was for your career. I mean, you could show it to other people and it's your future project. And one is to increase your, enhance your problem solving capacity. Now, third one, this one is really crucial, movie listing website. Why I'm saying this? Because you will understand a really important factor in programming, and that is CRUD. CRUD stands for create, read, update, and delete. So CRUD is what works in databases, right? So when you create a website of movie listing, what you need? Maybe you have to create a movie, right? List of movie. Maybe you have to fetch out search or like that, read, right? Maybe you have to update some information about that movie, or sometimes you might delete it also. Sometimes that movie can go flop or something. But anyways, so you must have these all things ready, CRUD. And that's why I'm saying this to you, that you must do this project of movie listing website. That's how you understand more about databases and how you manage MySQL and SQL and all these database languages, right? So it's really crucial for you to do a movie listing website. I would suggest every Python programmer to start off with this project of movie listing website. You can use Django if you don't want to use other platforms. Django is fine. If you want to learn more about Django, you can click on I button somewhere here and learn about Django, because I have some videos on Django already. If you are starting as a beginner, you don't have to be 100% perfect at the first try. There will be some error. You will have to find some test cases, try to add more features like that, right? So while you code all these projects, don't be perfectionist and don't try to be 100% perfect, because you are never 100% perfect. There can be some flaws, there can be some errors that will come in between, and you will find a solution and find a way to solve that on the way. So your task now would be to create one of these projects on Python programming and then put it on GitHub online, and just put the link in the comment down below and let me know. I'll be checking all of your projects and all these things. I'll also try to rate most of them. I'll try to see, okay, what is the things that can be made good out of it, and if you are already good, maybe I can just feature it in my next coming video. So comment down below your projects on Python programming. I get it, like everybody does not know Python programming. So if you want to learn more about Python programming, you can click in this video or this video to learn more about Python programming, and you can check my playlist out of Learn Python Programming. So this much for me today. I'll see you in the next one.